Sean Parnell was a Senate candidate, a Republican who'd been endorsed by President Donald Trump for the open US Senate race in Pennsylvania up until recently. He just suspended his campaign, and we had sort of been wondering if this was coming. The decision comes after a judge awarded Lori Snell, his estranged wife, primary physical custody and sole legal custody of the couple's three children, according to an order that was made public just yesterday. The judge also determined that Parnell committed some abusive acts towards his wife in the past. And so as a result of that, Sean Parnell put out this press release saying, "I strongly disagree with the ruling. I'm devastated by the decision." Oh, to be clear, he's devastated by the decision of the judge, not his own decision to abuse his wife. Strangling his wife was allegedly was a decision that he was allegedly okay with. He's not okay with the judge's decision. I just wanted to clarify that. He says he plans on asking the court to reconsider the decision, but I don't think that's going to be in time to save his candidacy. In any event, he can't continue with a Senate campaign. And I just want to be clear that while it is good that in the end, this guy who's alleged to have done all this terrible stuff won't be running, it took the custody decision to knock him out of consideration. The allegations that he had strangled his wife, that he had told her to go get an abortion and all that, that didn't cause him to, that was a step too far for the Republicans, potentially for the voters, certainly not for those endorsing him. So Trump released a statement back in September saying that Parnell, quote, has my complete and total endorsement. He'll make Pennsylvania very proud and will fight for election integrity, strong borders, our Second Amendment, energy jabs, so much more. He's just always fighting on the issues and with the one that he's supposed to love. That was not a problem for him for some reason. And that is weird, don't you think? Like, I get that with every candidate, there's gonna be things that they've perhaps said, votes that they've taken that we might disagree with. And you know, you never get the perfect candidate, but Pennsylvania didn't have a Republican who was, and let's be clear, when it comes to the issues, all we're saying is that they're slavishly devoted to Donald Trump and hadn't tried to choke his wife. No, I feel like we should have higher expectations for an entire state. In any event, he's gone at least. But while Sean Parnell might have dropped out of the running following a judicial decision about custody and all that, there are a number of Republican candidates running that still are facing pretty bad allegations. You have Herschel Walker running for US Senate in Georgia. Despite his support from Mitch McConnell and Donald Trump, Walker will eventually be forced to explain to voters what happened when his ex-wife alleged that he threatened her life by pointing a gun at her head. Walker also has allegations of threats from a former girlfriend. And now we get to do that exciting thing where we find out if another Republican will get to slide by in the way that Trump has. I mean, multiple allegations from women about criminal activity against Trump never hurt him. Maybe Herschel Walker will also have that. They are like super excited for him as a candidate. Donald Trump in particular, incredibly excited for Herschel Walker. All that stuff about pointing a gun at a woman's head, multiple women that he did abusive acts. We'll see if that bothers them. The pattern doesn't imply that it will. We also have Eric Greitens back in an attempt to reclaim his political career over in Missouri. He previously resigned after an affair with a hairdresser who accused him of tying her up and blackmailing her with nude photos. The accusations then spiraled into two additional criminal charges. We'll see, can they get past that? I mean, the person he blackmailed with nude photos was a woman, so I have a feeling it's probably not gonna bother them that much. Josh Mandel is running for the US Senate in Ohio while serving as a boss to his girlfriend. Already some of his campaign staffers resigned due to a toxic work environment. Yeah, but that's only affecting the workers. Why would Republicans care about that? Max Miller is a former Trump staffer. He was accused by Stephanie Grisham of being physically and emotionally abusive while they were dating. Miller disputes the claims and has sued Grisham. Again, this is all, we've known about this for a long time. Donald Trump actually referenced their relationship after Stephanie Grisham came out with revelations about what had happened in the White House and implied that basically she deserved whatever had happened. It wasn't a big deal. It's nothing to be worried about. You also have Larry Elder's former fiance, Alexandria Dadig, who broke up with Elder in 2015, alleged that when they were discussing breaking up, he brandished a 45 caliber revolver. Well, thankfully, we already dodged the Larry Elder bullet in this case. But man, they sure can fill up these elections with. Is it that they just don't have anyone who hasn't threatened a woman? Is it that they find those people particularly appealing? I don't know, but stay tuned for the 2022 elections to find out. And by the way, you do have one other weirdo who's gonna be running for office. Louie Gohmert announced Monday that he's running for Attorney General of Texas. Like, his qualification seemingly is that he's literally one of the dumbest Republican congressmen. And that is kind of competitive, honestly. Like, you have to work hard to stand out in comparison to them. So why would he want to be Attorney General of Texas? Well, almost certainly for things having to do with election integrity. Earlier this year, he made headlines when he delivered a lengthy diatribe on the House floor in which he downplayed the Capitol insurrection, falsely claimed that there's no evidence that the insurrectionists were armed when we know that they were. During the speech, he also pushed unfounded allegations against the FBI and the DOJ for unfairly going after Trump supporters in their investigation of the insurrection. Now, he has only limited ability as a congressman in the minority party to do anything about that. We'll see if he's Attorney General of Texas, if he can get more involved. In any event, he's a complete goofball. He's insane. He shouldn't be in any position of authority, let alone one where he could be interacting with the legal system of Texas or their elections. It's a great party. It's a great party. I look forward to the elections. I think it's gonna be great. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.